first I want to introduce is someone who's done more than many to publicise the plight of the Palestinian people and to build solidarity with Gaza. He's a figure who's inspired thousands. He's also put the lie to those who say that good political music, militant music, can't be good music. And I want to extend a big thank you from the Stop the War Coalition, and I want you to give a big, big cheer to Loki!
I want Obama to hear our voice, because Gordon Brown does not represent us! Mr. Obama has spoken about extending a hand of friendship to the Muslim world. Now, if he is serious about this hand of friendship, there are a number of things he must address. Where was your hand of friendship when 2 days into your presidency you dropped bombs on Pakistan? Listen, where was this hand of friendship when American citizen Tristan Anderson was shot in the head with a gas canister by the IDF for peacefully protesting about 2 weeks ago? Where was Obama's voice? He was as quiet as a mouse. Be a man! Be a man, Obama! You talk about getting rid of the lobby groups in Washington. Then why is APAC still in your pockets to the tune of $30 billion over the next decade? Why are APAC still determining who is and who isn't in your administration? Why did you allow APAC to chase Chaz Freeman away from your administration? Why is your chief of staff's name Ram Israel Emanuel? Why is your chief of staff a former IDF soldier? Why do you still have the same defense secretary, Robert Gates, that George Bush had? This is not about black and white. This is about wrong and right. And we should never, ever give this man the benefit of the doubt based purely on his race, because that makes us just as bad as any races anywhere in the world. Now, something I want to say about Afghanistan is an interesting fact which I learned only the other day, is since the US-led occupation and invasion of Afghanistan, the heroin coming out of that country has increased 33-fold. Yes. Now all that tells me is that the United States and the CIA are better drug dealers than the Taliban ever were. This is something you, Obama, must address. Do not even look at me until you address these facts. Why is the president of Afghanistan a former CIA operative and a former UNICAL consultant? We know these facts and we are not stupid. As far as Iraq, America owes Iraq billions and billions and billions of dollars. Billions of Iraqi money has been siphoned out of Iraq by American companies. Now this is something you must address. When I say payback, you say Iraq. Payback! Iraq! Payback! Iraq! Payback! Iraq! Okay, so one point I want to make also is that the United States approximately every single year spends $400 billion on weapons. Now if there's one thing the world needs less of, is weapons. Okay, weapons and burgers. So spend the $324 billion on giving people food, because that can eradicate extreme poverty on a worldwide level. So spend that. I've only got 1 more minute, so I'm going to be very quick. Okay, listen. This is for Kosovo, Iraq, Baghdad, Chechnya, all those apostle 9-11 in America, Afghanistan, Kashmir, Bosnia, and Darfur. Who really profits when the G20 start war? Congo, Somalia, Eritrea, Rwanda, Lebanon, Liberia, Serbia, and Uganda. Around the world, too many children buried in vain. I won't carry on, cause there's too many to name. This is for Palestine, Ramallah, West Bank, Gaza. This is for the child that is searching for an answer. I wish I could take your tears and replace them with laughter. Long live Palestine! So we have three words. Yes, we can. But I have three words for Barack Hussein Obama. Be a man. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Loki.